Good morning, student. In our previous video, we have started our third chapter, that was force. And in this chapter, we have studied about definition of force. We have studied about definition. We have studied about effects of force. These two things we have studied in our previous video. But from today, this video, we are going to study about some other aspects of the force. Like first we will study about unit of force. The first topic today we will study unit of force. The unit of force is Newton. The standard unit of force is Newton. To measure and describe the effect of force acting on a surface, we need a quantity that takes into the account of the force applied and the area over which it is applied. Such quantity is pressure. Pressure is force exerted per unit area. One more new terms is being discussed here, and that is pressure. As we have studied just now that Newton is the unit of the force, which is symbolized as capital N. Now one new term is given, pressure. Pressure you can define. Pressure is force exerted per unit area. And the formula for pressure is force upon area. This is the formula for calculating the magnitude of the pressure. Now let us move to the next topic, and the next topic is type of forces. Our next topic is type of force. Now within this type of force, force has been derived or described into two part, and the first is contact force, and the second is non-contact force. Contact and non-contact. By its name, contact means by touching, that is by physical appearance, and non-contact means there is no contact between two object. And in contact force, there is physical contact between two object. And again, this contact force is being distributed into two different type of force. The first is muscular force, and second is frictional force. And this non-contact force is distributed into again three type. The first is magnetic force, second is electrostatic force, and third is gravitational force. These are the mainly five types of force which we are going to study today. First we will discuss about contact force. Just now I have told contact force. Contact force means the force which is applied by one object on another object, and both the object are physically linked together. It means both the objects are connected physically, both our objects are touching each other. Let us see the book. A force which can be exerted by an object on an other object only through physical touching is called contact force. It means the physical touch between two objects should be there. That will be called as contact force. And where physical touch is not there, that will be non-contact force. A force which can be exerted by an object on another object even from a distance. It means if no contact is there, that force will work from a distance, like magnetic. Have you seen magnetic magnets? They are attracting or repulsing from some distance without getting touched with each other. electrostatic force also, gravitational force also. These three forces are non-contact. There is no physical contact between two object. Let us see one by one all these type of five forces. The first force which we will discuss today is frictional force. Frictional is the term which is made by friction, and friction means resistance produced in opposite direction of motion. We can define frictional force as, frictional force is a type of force which act in opposite direction for you can say that slow down of the motion of an object. Let us make it more clear from some example. If we will understand the example, then resistance force will be quite clear to all of us. Resistance means the force. This frictional force, it is also a force which is applied in opposite direction. We can also write the force which is applied on opposite direction is called frictional force. Let us take an example. Suppose a ball is rolling. A ball is rolling down the ground. This ball is moving and rolling down the ground. After some time, we can see that ball, by covering certain distance, it becomes in rest. It comes at rest. After moving certain distance, it comes at rest. Now, as earlier we have studied that the effect of force, in effect of force, we have studied that force can stop a moving body. It means this body was in motion, and it, after covering some distance, the body comes at rest. It means that there is some force which was acting in this body. At this point, we have applied the force and we have kicked the ball, and the ball was moving slowly in this direction. After a certain time, the ball gets stopped. It means that there was some force which was acting on the ball to stop it, and that force will be opposite in direction. That's why that type of force is called frictional force. One more example we can take. We might have seen in cricket match, when a batsman hits a ball through the ground and ball starts rolling on the ground to move towards the boundary, and after reaching some part of the boundary, it suddenly slows down and it stops. Then there was some force which was acting in the ball for stopping that ball. That type of force is called frictional force. Let us take one more example. Suppose you are riding a bicycle and you have pedaled the bicycle, and bicycle starts moving, and after you just stop the pedaling of the bicycle, then your bicycle will slowly come on rest. And when it slowly comes on rest, it means that some force was applied on your bicycle to stop the motion of the bicycle. That force was opposite in direction. It is actual force, and friction is opposite in direction, and friction is applied slowly so that after some times or after covering some distance, the ball or any object will come to rest. That type of force is called frictional force, or you can say that opposite force is called frictional force. Second, we will discuss about muscular force. Muscular force are those force which are applied by our muscles, that means our body parts. You can see in the example given in your book, no diagram is given in your book. let us understand by our own concept that muscular force, the force which is applied by the muscles part of our body for lifting any object, for lifting any object from ground. Suppose we want to lift a bucket of water, that means we have to apply force from our hand, and that force will be applied by our muscles, that will be called as muscular force. Next, third type of force is magnetic force. Magnetic force, the force applied by magnet. The force applied by magnet is called magnetic force. There are two type of force which is applied by magnet. First is attraction and second is repulsion. These are the two way in which magnet applies a force. As we have all we have seen magnet, and we have seen that like pole repel each other, and like and unlike pole attract each other. Without any physical contact, there is attraction and repulsion. That is called magnetic force. The fourth type of force we will see, gravitational force. Gravitational force is also a type of force which our earth exerts on the body. The force exerted by earth on the body or on any object is called gravitational force. We can define gravitational force as the force exerted by earth on our body or on any object is called gravitational force. Like, due to this gravitational force, a table, when it is kept on the surface of the floor, it is kept there only. If gravitational force is not there in the earth, then everything will be flying in the atmosphere. And the last is electrostatic force. The force exerted by an object when sharing of electrons takes place. Let us make it more, because this electron you haven't studied till earlier. That's why I will make this electrostatic force with an example. It will be clear to you all. You might have done in your class rubbing the scale on your hair. You might have done, you have taken a scale and you start rubbing that scale on the hair, on your hair, and after rubbing of the scale, there is a transfer of electrons between the scale and your hair. It means that scale gets charged. Now scale gets charged, and if you will bring that scale with a tiny little bits of paper, and you might have observed that bits of paper start getting attracted towards the scale. There is some force acting, and that force will be called as electrostatic force. Hope that up to this topic it is quite clear to you all. And in our next video, we will start from deep concept for learning frictional force.